Greetings and welcome to another episode of Sonic Odyssey, the music video channel dedicated to bringing you the last 5 decades or so of music in review and discussion format. Before we dive into today's topic, let's get the housekeeping out of the way. Firstly, please be sure to like the video by clicking the thumbs up button. That helps the YouTube algorithm get the video out to more people and potential viewers, so that's really important. And also, you can share the video by clicking the share button below. You can share through Facebook, Twitter, and many other social media networks. Also, I would ask you to please subscribe to the channel, and you can, if you want, you don't have to, but if you want, you can click the little bell icon next to the subscribe button, and that way you'll be notified each time I post a new video. Finally, I would humbly ask you to please consider visiting my Patreon page, for which there is a link in the show description below. There you'll see the different tiers that are available to help sponsor the channel. And you can have your name listed in the end credits of each video. As you'll see, there are patrons who have their name listed at the end of this video. And you can even go so far as to select an album for me to review here on the channel. That's the housekeeping out of the way. Easy, simple. Let's get on to today's topic. Today we're going to be talking about one of Sweden's top melodic death metal bands, which goes by the name of Amon Amarth. Amon Amarth is a name that they chose from the J.R.R. Tolkien universe of Middle-earth, which comes from one of these fictional languages that J.R.R. Tolkien created called, Sindarin, and that is the name in Sindarin that J.R.R. Tolkien created for Mount Doom in the world of Middle-earth. Amon Amarth formed in 1992, and they are a quintet. There are 3 members from the original lineup that are still in the band, and we'll get into naming them and discussing them in a minute. They're sometimes classified as Viking metal, but that's in a classification that the band themselves strongly disagree with and adamantly oppose, because they insist they are a melodic death metal band and not a Viking metal band. Viking metal is really something that's a very different genre. It has a great range of styles of music. It can be from folk or black or heavier music, power metal. There are many, many different styles of music and genres of music that, when they use Viking motifs and themes as their lyrical content and background, they are typically classified as Viking metal. Amon Amarth does make a great deal of use of Viking mythos and history in their lyrical content, but they really adamantly oppose the idea of being classified as a Viking metal band. They firmly insist they are a melodic death metal band, and they are. Their musical style is very much in keeping with what makes melodic death metal that style. And so for those of you who are not really familiar with melodic death metal, or why it differs from death metal or other forms of heavy metal or extreme metal music, melodic death metal is typified by its drawing its musical inspirations from the traditional heavy metal roots from bands such as Thin Lizzy or Judas Priest, up through the new wave of British heavy metal, especially bands like Iron Maiden. And they take this melodic guitar styling and guitar harmonies, and they overlay it with the death style vocals, that usually gutturals and growls. So that's the kind of vocal style that is more associated with death metal. So when you put these two together, you end up with melodic death metal. Today we're going to be looking at and listening to the 7th studio album from Amon Amarth, which is entitled Twilight of the Thunder God and was released in 2008. This is an album that pretty much broke the band on the charts, success-wise and commercially. It was their highest ranking at the time, charting album on the Swedish charts, coming in at number 11, and on the Billboard Top 200 it came in at number 50. The title of the album and the title track of the album draw their name from the a story of the Norse god Thor slaying the Midgard serpent, which goes by the name, and forgive me if I butcher this, Jormungandr. As I said, the band is a quintet, and they're currently composed of Johan Hegg on vocals, Olivai Mikkonen on guitar, lead guitar, Ted Lundstrom on bass guitar, and these are the three original members of the band that still remain. They're joined currently by Johan Soderberg on rhythm guitar, and he's been a member of the band since 1998, so he's recorded on all but their first album. And they're also joined by, and I'm really worried about butchering his pronunciation, Joke Wahlgren on drums. And if I'm mispronouncing that, somebody can tell me in the comments, or please forgive me, I certainly don't mean any disrespect. He's been their drummer since 2016. He replaced the drummer that had been with the band for roughly, I think, 16 or 17 years by the name of Frederick Anderson. And Frederick Anderson plays the drums on the album that we're looking at today, Twilight of the Thunder God. Twilight of the Thunder God, while certainly the highest charting album for them up to that point in time, would probably not have gotten where it did if it weren't for its preceding albums. You know, even going back as far as their debut LP, they were garnering acclaim and success. They've always been, from that debut album, on the upward trajectory. They had, you know, modest, if not great or phenomenal, chart success and commercial success. They definitely had critical success and a great fan base, and they've only been continuing to grow their fan base by legions over the ensuing years, especially since the release of Twilight of the Thunder God. This was certainly an album that broke them for a vast majority of people, and the video that they did for one of the tracks from the album, entitled Guardians of Asgard, was very much a part of their great success. But now let's get a feel for what Amon Amarth bring to the table when it comes to the sonic realm. And we're going to do that by taking a little bit of a listen to a track from the album. This is its second track, and this is the opening portion of the song, Free Will Sacrifice. In this snippet, you get a feel for the guitar sound that the band has, and it is something that they've really finely tuned and honed over the years. They have this kind of rugged, yet chugging and tremolo-picking style of guitar work that has a raw, sawblade-esque kind of sound to it. And also you hear the marvelous vocals of Johan Hegg, who is really a very important part of the Amon Amarth sound. A lot of melodic death metal or death metal vocalists will use this same sort of deep bass, growling, guttural vocal style, but Johan Hegg has this extremely powerful voice, and yet he comes through very distinguishable. You can hear the vocals that he's singing, you can understand the lyrics, and they're often quite interesting. I mean, that they tell marvelous stories. Amon Amarth does a fantastic job of weaving tales of Viking mythos and history and honor and sacrifice, and so having him perform these powerful lead vocals with tremendous clarity, as well as this deep guttural sound, is a very important part of what makes Amon Amarth sound the way it is. Twilight of the Thunder God is basically an album that has 10 songs. It is under 44 minutes in length. It's got a few guest appearances on it, which are kind of nice. It includes, on the song I mentioned earlier, Guardians of Asgard, it has L.G. Petrov of Entombed fame helping with the vocals on that track. And then there is another gentleman whose name I'm really worried about pronouncing, Rupe Latvala, who is from rhythm guitar player of Children of Bodom, and he performs the lead guitar work on the title track, Twilight of the Thunder God, and they also have a little bit on another track from Apocalyptica. The track is Live for the Kill, and they bring a beautiful, with their, because Apocalyptica is a symphonic metal band, but they really are emphasis on symphonic. They play, you know, cello, oboe, viola, violin. It's a string oriented group, and so they really have a very symphonic style in their sound. And they come in this song "Live for the Kill" with a beautiful break in the song where they lend tremendous atmosphere to the sound of the song. And so it's a marvelous little touch to the music. But let's listen to a little bit more from Amon Amarth's Twilight of the Thunder God with a snippet from a track later in the album entitled The Hero. My soul is death and misery. I am an evil man. The Hero is a song that is basically about a mercenary, a sellsword, who has a little bit of a personal transition in his life and realizes that perhaps he's not the hero that he believes himself to be. And as you heard in the snippet that I chose for you, there's a little bit of the vocal at the beginning of that snippet where he realizes that he is an evil man. And then it goes into this, you know, guitar interlude before coming back to the song proper. This particular piece I thought was a nice section to show the style of guitar play, again, the wonderful sound that they have developed in their band over the years. And also, once more, we have the marvelous performance from Johan Hegg. Twilight of the Thunder God is a treat to listen to. Even though the lyrical themes can be a bit dark or a bit heavy at times, the presentation and performance that is given by the band is bright and optimistic. There is with Johan Hegg leading the band as the front man of the band, he himself is a man of stature. He's a big guy, and he is a very, from everything that I have personally seen and read about him and in the concert performances that I've seen of them, he's a very gregarious and good-natured man, and so he brings that through regardless of the color or texture of the lyrics that he might be singing. He still comes across with this ever-optimistic sounding guttural and strong low tone voice. It's really an interesting juxtaposition of his vocal delivery and the quality that it evokes within the listener. Amon Amarth have released 4 albums since Twilight of the Thunder God, and they've since parted ways with drummer Frederick Anderson. As I said before, they have brought in the new drummer, and he's appeared on, I believe, 2 albums with them now. The most recent album having been Berserker. And they're possibly going to be putting out some new material within the year, or maybe beginning of next year. It's hard to say. In February of 2022, they teased us by putting out a new single and a new video entitled Put Your Back Into the Ore. And check it out on YouTube. It's a wonderful song and a really beautiful cinematic video. But it might be the latter before we see an album from them. They're planning on a fall tour with Machine Head and Halo Effect. Machine Head is a band from America, and led by the semi-notorious Rob Flynn. And the Halo Effect is a new band that's formed predominantly from the people who originally formed another very famous melodic death metal band in Sweden known as In Flames. And they're going to be on tour through the fall, so it's uncertain if we're going to be seeing a new studio album from Amon Amarth anytime soon, but they did tease us with that single, so for those fans of us anticipating a new release. It has been 3 years since their last album. Hopefully they won't leave us waiting too long. For now, I hope you've enjoyed listening to me talk a little bit about Amon Amarth. I hope you enjoyed the snippets of music that I played. I really feel Twilight of the Thunder God is a great album to introduce you to the band if you're not familiar with them. If you are familiar with them, then you should certainly be checking this album as well as their catalog out. They have a fantastic catalog of albums both before Twilight and since, and they're extremely talented at bringing their studio sound to the stage and performing wonderfully live. Every performance that I've seen of theirs, and I've seen probably, I think I own on DVD and Blu-ray at least 4 or 5 different concerts of theirs from over the past 12 years or 13 years, and they're just wonderful. They're just fantastic to see perform live. They very often adorn the stage with Viking elements, and they'll maybe be a portion of a Viking longship, and they've even had performers come on stage to enact battle scenes with shield and sword or axe. So I hope you enjoyed learning about that. I give Twilight of the Thunder God by Amon Amarth from 2008, 4.5 out of 5 stars. I really feel it's a strong album and a great listen, a great introduction to the band. And once more, if you're familiar with them, you should really also check out their back catalog if you are not familiar with them going back to their very origins, to their roots from 1998. They really have a great sound, and you can see the maturity and development and progression of their style of melodic death metal over the course of their catalog. I'm sure you can find their music on Spotify, Deezer, iTunes or Apple Music, Amazon Music, and probably you can get physical copies. I think I have of their 11 albums, I think I have 8 actual CDs, and the rest I purchased digitally. They have deluxe versions available, and some of the deluxe versions of the physical copies even come with concert DVDs packaged in with them, and they've been extremely well priced. I mean, I remember when I bought Twilight of the Thunder God many, many years ago in 2008, 2009, that it had a concert DVD as the bonus disc, and the price of it was still under $10. So that was a marvelous steal of a deal. So please check them out, and please also remember to like, share, and subscribe to the channel. Please, I beg you, subscribe to the channel so you can see other videos from a wide range of different genres and styles of music. And also, please consider visiting my Patreon page. I thank you for your time and attention. Until next time, peace, be well, bye-bye.